Hello Inventors, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create UFO game using MIT App Inventor. So let's see, click on the start project. My project name is new UFO game. Now first of all we need to design our game. So in the left side you will find the drawing and animation option. So just drag and drop the canvas and make this hide and fill with this fill pattern like this. I'm going to use your click on the user interface and I'm going to use your one button and make that button width is at least 90% like this. Click on that screen and make the thing in a center like this, all thing in a center, cool. Now click on that button and just change that text and font type, font size and all. So like 18, background color is something orange, change to the text to a start game. Okay, and make it font bold like this. Now, in the canvas, I'm gonna use here one background image. So in the right side, you'll find the background image option. Click on upload file, click on choose file. As you can see here, I have one bg.jpg. So I'm gonna upload this file and click on OK. It's just a game background. So you can use any background image here, okay? Now I need here some UFOs. So what I'll do, I need here image spread. So first what I'll do, I'm gonna just click on the screen and make sure that background color should be black like this. Now in the left side, you'll find the drawing animation. I'll see the image split. So I'm going to use your one image split for the home. And I'm going to just click on picture and upload file and choose file. So I have three images here. So you can see here UFO1.png. That one is our home. Okay. Home. So click on OK. And as you can see this one. So I'm going to just make this hide and with this, like click on pixel and just say here, suppose 50-50 pixel, and let's see how this will work. Okay, so it's too small, so I'm gonna just add to the pixel to the 100, so 100 will be fine like this. Cool, so it's great. So I'm gonna just make it here, and now what I'll do, I'm just gonna copy paste do three times this. So here I'm gonna use here one police. Okay, so this one is the second one is police and third one is me, suppose. Okay, so we are in the third one. So I'm gonna just change the police UFO, like they will try to catch us. So suppose this one, okay, and click on OK. And another one is someone, this one, okay. So third one. So what I'll do, just first just make it fixed it UFO police UFO like this, and the third one is our. Click on upload file and choose file. This is VR UFO3. Cool. Now we need to just, you know, run and make sure that we need to, you know, go to our home. Okay, that's our safer point. This is so you can resize all these images. Okay, you can check with your AI companion using this connect AI companion to check all these images working fine in your phone or not. Okay, and you can resize all these images. Cool. So what I'll do, I'm just gonna do one thing here. I'm gonna just make this image split one should be visible off, because once I start the playing game, so I will display that. Okay, so let's go to the blog, and once I click on the button one to start this game, so I need to display my image split one. Okay, this one image split that I have just recently hide. Okay, so image split one, so image split one set to the visible on. This one, and that should be visible true. Okay, now what I need to do, I need to move that third one. Okay, this is me, suppose this UFO, I need to move using the mobile sensor. So for that I need to use some sensors. In the left side you'll find the sensors, and you'll see here the orientation sensor. Just drag and drop this, and I need a clock sensor also. Okay, like this. So I'm gonna just make this clock should be disabled for now. Let's go to the block. So once I move my phone, so that UFO should also move, okay, left, right, okay, in the direction. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to use here like go to the design. I'll see this is the image split 3. So image split 3 dot move, you'll see here the move, this one, call it here. Now I need a maths, I need, here's one formula we need to use here, okay. So plus icon. And what I need to do, I need to get the image split 3 dot x value, dot x value. So go to the image split 3 dot x value, this one. Okay, that value. Now what I need to do, I need to use here the maths formula by multiplication like this one. I need to multiply by the minus 1 and minus 1 value, okay? I need to multiply that minus value with the orientation sensor dot roll. So you'll see the orientation sensor and the roll is here like this. And after the multiplication, I need to divide that value by any number. If you want to make that movement speed is slow, then you need to increase that value, okay? So how I'll do that? So first I'm going to use a maths, and I'm going to use here the divide, this one. Under the divide, I'm going to use that value and divide by, the whole value should be divided by, you can divide it by 2, 3, 4, whatever, but I'm going to divide it by 8. That will decrease the speed of that my component, okay? If you want to increase the speed of your component, okay, whenever you try to move your phone, so you can just decrease that value, okay? So just copy paste an X, and that should be Y, and that roll should be pitch. That's it, okay? So this will move, okay? That orientation sensor will move our image split 3. So what I need to do here, I need to assign the speed for the image split 3, okay? So image split 3, and you'll see here the speed option, this one. So we need to assign the image split speed, and you can assign that value to the anything like 5, 10 or whatever. So I'm gonna just define the 5, okay? Okay, this is done. Now what I need to do here, someone is collide with this, okay? This collide with this police. Now how that police will move, okay? How this will work? So it's very simple. What I need to do here, once that's changed, orientation change, I need to create that image split. Which image split? This one is 2. That image split 2 should follow the image split 3. So image split 2 dot move, okay? Toward target, and the target is image split 3. So image split 3 value like this. So that will move to that image split 3. Simple. We need to make our game winner or loser, or how this will game over or something. So for that, what I'll do, once the image split collide, okay, suppose this is our image split, right? So once that image split collide with that police, it means that we have to go into child. But if we collide with our image split 1, it means with our home. So this is like we reached our home, okay? So how I'll define this, so it's simple. Go to the block, and once the image split 3, okay, collide with, so we need to use a user condition, okay, that if control, if that other is, I'm going to use the logic is here, and if that get other value is equal to the image split 1, okay, image split 1, okay, sorry, this should be, okay, if that image split 1, then we can just say here, I'm going to use here a notifier. So click on the user interface, use the notifier like this, go to the block, use the notifier here like this, use some dialog like this, just call it here, use any message like this, and just fill anything like good job, and just say here welcome to home like this. And you can just say in the button text like I want to go back or something, okay? I want to go back, or I want to go outside, okay, like this you can say. And if that else if, okay, so if else if, I'm gonna just use copy paste this value, and if the get other value is 2, it means the police. So I can just say like, let's go to the jail, okay, sorry bro, or something, whatever you want to say. And let's say please leave me or something like that. I can say a button here, okay? So what I'll do, so let's make this game more complex, like if you try to catch your home, right, so that home is also moved to the some other positions, okay, automatically. So I'll do simple thing, go to the block, and how this will move. So once the timer is enabled, so when you click on the button when to start game, so that timer should enable. So clock timer enabled should be true like this. And how this will fire, like this timer should fire in every 3 seconds. So I'm going to use 3000. And what I will do this once this fire, so I can move that image spirit to value. Okay, like this one is value one, sorry, one image spirit one, move to the any random any random position. So like you can use, or I'm going to use a random value like this. Okay, so I'm going to just use 400 like this. So that's the overall app. Okay, it's really very simple and amazing. This is very simple. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, like this video and share this video. Make sure that images should be high, visible off. Okay, have a nice day, be safe, bye bye. How this will work, so let me just show you. Let's click on the start game and you can see you have your home. So you need to go to your home. So that home is also moving. So I'm just moving this, but that one is also moving to me. Like, see, this one is trying to catch me. Now let me just move to my again home. Yes, done, right? As you can see, welcome to home. I want to go outside again and I need some rest. So you can do anything. Now let's try to again. So once you go outside again, and if that UFO will catch you, like suppose like this. Oh, see, welcome to jail. I want to go outside again, please, and take me to jail like this.